Hello, fellow YouTubers, it's me again. Now it's time for another Ultraman figure review, except this time it's not a monster, it's one of the Ultraman himself. The original Ultraman, who first appeared in 1966's Ultraman. Now, the strange thing is, Ultraman was obviously very popular, but it wasn't the first Ultra series. The first one was actually Ultra Q, which kind of dealt like, you know, it could think of like maybe the X-Files or something like that, where they deal with weird and unusual things. Except they were, of course, giant monsters. So yeah, the Ultraman series comes right after Ultra Q. So, pretty weird. This, of course, is the original Ultraman. The original Ultraman TV series was one of the first, and probably one of the only few ones to actually get a U.S. dubbing and release in the U.S., because other series like Ultra 7, Return of Ultraman, and stuff did not follow. There were Malaysian dubs, or maybe quote-unquote international dubs, but never in a U.S. dub, and it wasn't really released in the U.S. I even asked my parents, and they said they saw the original Ultraman back when it was still new, but they never saw any of the other TV series. They said there was no Ultraman this or Ultraman that. It was just Ultraman. So that kind of sucks. So yeah, this is the original Ultraman, definitely my favorite Ultraman. You know, besides Mebius and stuff like that. You know, just Ultraman, he's original, he's awesome. This is the box. Ultra Hero Series number 1. Ultraman in Japanese kanji or katana, whatever you want to call it, made by Bandai. There's a picture of him. And the picture of him on the side. You got a nice profile pic with him and Red King. It's got some data up here. And $13.99, pretty good price. Down here, as you can see, it says Ultra Hero Series with pictures of all the Ultraman who were released up to that point. You know, up to Gaia. Got another pic up here, so that's cool. I'm not trying to keep him mint in box. I just keep him in the box, you know, to help him from getting dusty and stuff. Because I tell you, I have to clean up, like, maybe other a month or so. Yeah, it's really dusty. Sometimes I have to clean my fingers with a damn cloth just to get all the dust out. And, of course, good old Ultraman's just fine with his box. So let's take him out. These guys do come with tags, so in case you're wondering about, oh, do they come with a tag? Yes, they do. They come in these, you just gotta put their feet in there. So yeah, it's pretty good. While I'm at it, let me get his tag right now. Here we go. Here's Ultraman's tag. They come with the tag in the box, so don't worry. Ultra Hero number 7, got the same pick as on the box, some data. Number 1. Got info about Ultraman as well as all the other Ultra figures in the series. Goes on to, I think, Ultraman Cosmos, I'm not entirely sure. So yeah. And this is Ultraman himself, the original. He's easily one of my favorite, of course, like I just said, and he's got an awesome design. He's one of the most widely recognizable characters you could, you know, ever come across. Because, you know, how many people look just like this, if you know what I mean? Now, if you're looking for a figure with less articulation, you're better off with light and sound figures or whatever, because there are, like, figures that are this size, but they come with, like, whole bunch of articulation, Shogokin toys, like Mechagodzilla or whatever. This is just a typical Bandai figure. It only has 3. The arms, of course, so you can have them like this. And the waist, which rotates like this. So he's really not meant to be played with. He's more of a display figure. And if you saw Godzilla films videos, the Ultraman and Godzilla, you can see it's pretty hard for him to make some videos because of the limited articulation points of these figures. Shogokin toys or the other metal diecast figures that they're released, those are definitely work better, but you know, way more expensive, that's a problem. So yeah, in terms of paint job, let's go to that. He's got the nice metallic look, just like he should have. Nice red color. The designs on his body are perfect, just how they should be. Got a little details there on the legs and under the feet. They got no details, just the writing. Hands are nicely done. They got this nice, you know, pose. Because usually fights like this anyway, but, you know, not like that, but you know what I mean. So yeah, you've got the face is nicely done. Got the buggy eye look and the mouth here. Weird ears and the spine down here. And of course the color timer. Nice color. Perfect choice. So yeah, he's pretty good. Let's try scaling now. Let's get some monsters out here. First of all, Gomorrah.
Of course. This is pretty accurate because Gomorrah is about this size in the TV series anyway.
Let's see. I got some other monsters over here. Let's try Red King.
Well, I did most of this with these guys' figure reviews, but you know. Just to show you guys again, this is more or less okay. I think Red King's supposed to be bigger, but you know. So yeah.
Now let's get one more out here. One of my favorite characters. Good old Bolton.
Like I said in Bolton's review, perfect scaling with Ultraman. Absolutely perfect. Ultraman versus Bolton. So yeah, that's awesome. We've got great scaling with him. Let's try Godzilla now. Sure, this could work. This could totally work. Ultraman versus Godzilla. How about Final Wars Godzilla?
Final Wars Godzilla is a little too small.
Like, you know, he just should be a little bigger, but that works just fine. It's okay.
So yeah, he's got good paint job, good detail. Good on point, you know, the scaling.
Pretty poor articulation points, but oh well. Nothing you can do about that. He's just a Bandai figure.
Now, I told you about his history a little bit. He also appeared not only in his own TV series, but a few others, sort of like cameos. He appeared in Return of Ultraman, you know, like a few times. He also appeared in, you know, Ultraman Ace a few times. I think he was in Taro. Yeah, he was in the opening scene of Taro. And he's appeared a few other times in other TV series. He also appeared in Ultraman Tiga, which was supposedly a different continuation story, you know, like how the Millennium films and the Godzilla movies are. So he appeared, and that was kind of weird. I was like, ooh, are these two series connected? And so that was cool. He's also appeared in Ultraman Mebius and stuff like that. And his most recent appearance was in Ultra Galaxy Daikaiju Battle, where he was originally imprisoned in some kind of large mountainous region, and Rey, the main character, eventually found out he was actually the hero, Raymon, who was kind of like an Ultraman hero himself, but he's kind of human-sized. And his mission was to revive Ultraman. So yeah, they haven't explained what exactly Ultraman's purpose in the TV series is, but it's most likely going to explain in the sequel, Ultra Galaxy Neo. So anyway, there's that. What kind of sucks for Ultraman is in his latest appearance in Ultra Galaxy Daikaiju Battle, in the final scene, the main characters were escaping from the planet, which was being about to be destroyed at the time. Their spaceship was being brought down by King Joe Black. I don't feel like getting his figure, so you know. But Ultraman appeared after he was revived and managed to free them from King Joe Black. Unfortunately, he fell back to the planet. He fell back to the planet with King Joe Black still holding him, and the planet was apparently destroyed. Or at least the whole place was set ablaze. If you see the episode, you know what I mean. Just like the whole planet is covered in fire and just completely demolished. So we don't know if Ultraman survived. Though we do know King Joe Black survived because he appeared in the new Ultra Galaxy TV series, Galaxy Neo. So his fate is still unknown. But that's basically it. Ultraman's a really cool character and he's one of my favorites. He's got a good Bandai figure, just doesn't work for articulation points. If you want that, you're going to have to get some kind of light and sound figures or even some Jigoken figures. So yeah, he gets a 4 to 5 just for being pure awesomeness. And, well, that's pretty much it. I'll see you guys later. Schwatch!